Giuseppe, in one of the interviews you said, I used to vote left. I think the ideologies of the 20th century are no longer adequate.
Why?
So this ties into, you know, liberalism, democracy, all the things we were hoping for that it would make our society vibrant are no longer there. At the same time, Italy is not only the country where the fascist movement of Mussolini started, where the granddaughter of Mussolini is now winning the most votes in the city council of Rome, where you have the Brothers Whatever party by Mrs. Meloni, who is also, I dare to say, a fascist party. When you have had long time before Trump, you had Berlusconi. So, two questions. What is it that, according to you, make fascism so popular among people? Why are people, again, embracing this idea, again, of the 20th century? And if, as you all know, that can never be the solution, and if the ideologies of the 20th century are also not working anymore, then what?
According to your question, Rob, in every system, of course, we have, when there is a crisis of democracy, there is a crisis. I already said that there is an authoritarian direction, suggestion to go in that direction. And sometimes, I say something not so popular, also the culture, historically, produces also national identity. Mm-hmm. That means the different sensibilities, cultural sensibility. And of course, in some version, they interpret the national traditional identity as a factor that is at the root of the racism, of homosexuality, discrimination, or different for the other. Mm-hmm. You don't know. You don't want to recognize the other. You don't want that in the other. The other can reveal your humanity. Mm-hmm. And this is an approach that is connected to fear, to frustration, to the crisis that you are living, your situation, your conditions. Mm-hmm. That's why there are the premises in order to have fascism everywhere.
What makes fascism so attractive to people? Why are they so fond of it? Because that's the real thing. Mm-hmm. It's coming from bottom up. No, it's not imposed. It's not North Korea. It's not China. It's, quote unquote, what the people want.
Well, I think Giuseppe is absolutely correct to point out using the other to create fear. Fear is an incredibly powerful emotion. And some on the right are quite adept at co-opting people's fear. And so I think what we see happening is, and certainly with COVID is a striking example of this. There's a significant minority of people who have authoritarian personality. These are people who need to follow. They like homogeneity. They're afraid of change. They want stability, and that doesn't mean, you know, it's not political. It's not that they're more reactionary or more liberal. It's not that at all. They will. It's completely psychological.
I still find it difficult to understand how clowns. Berlusconi was a clown, right? Was a clown. Trump is a clown, right? I mean, listen. So how come that?
We think so. I struggled for a long time because I tried to be as objective as humanly possible in writing my first book because I knew that I would be accused of being unobjective. I guess English is my first and only language, and yet I'm struggling to find the word. Anyway, that I needed to be as honest as possible about who Donald was, what we were dealing with, and I kept thinking, I'm missing something. Tens of millions of people see in him something that I'm not seeing. What is it? And then I realized, I'm not missing anything. It's just that the things about him they admire, I hate. they admire the ignorance, the lack of intellectual curiosity. They admire his ability to get away with lying. They admire, I think, more than anything else, the fact that he is a failure at everything he's ever done, and yet he's been allowed to succeed time after time after time.
I studied another personality, which was Hitler, when I wrote my book. And I think I liked what Giuseppe said, because politics, we know that it hates a vacuum. If it's not filled with hope, it's filled with fear. So fear is very important. But also, is the one what brings people together is the targeting of an enemy, even if it's an imaginary enemy, because that brings people together. So Trump was very good in creating enemies for his audience, and in that sense, and fear at the same time, apart from stupidity and bringing down the level so that they feel that they have something to communicate with him.
Creating enemies by exploiting what's always been there, the horrific racism and misogyny.
Exactly.
You know, which made it easier because the ground had already been softened for centuries.
Yeah. So.